Mini chapter 28, Jaymi creates Evelyn's soundtrack. Jaymi smiles unseen through the window and across the plaza outside the Melrose Avenue building. It's time to create Evelyn's soundtrack. This will be a joy. Just as when she jumped into picturing her own irises before she'd been given them, or even quite knew what physical seeing is, so now she strains from side to side, trying to take the lead in making her own soundtrack before she knows anything about audio. The directions she's straining in are quirky ones too, because the sounds that she's zeroing in on bear little relation to anything he expects she will hear on the streets of LA after he releases her into meat space. Quote, "The linnet brings with it a breath of gorse-clad Dorset hillsides and summer days," unquote, she informs him, in a way that's still pre-verbal and yet is somehow so mellifluous as to smack of elocution training. "What?" Jaymi murmurs. "What are you talking about, Evelyn? Where did you get that from? That's not you at all." He frowns and shakes his head. It's cheeky and no mistake. Surely he's the boss here? But she's off, so he resigns himself to letting her go where she will, merely hovering nearby, ready to rein her back if she veers ridiculously far afield. Here she is at a circular window on the ground floor of a grand country house, peering out across an ornamental lake to mist hanging blue above fields in twilight where the linnets sing. She clambers through the window and stands on a dancing ledge of stone for a moment, jumps to the ground, then sets off around the lake and through a moonlit field beyond, with linnet's song loud in the air. While she runs, ailanthus shoots pierce the earth and spring up close beside her in lines from their suckers underground. The birdsong fades as this space becomes a thorn field. The sky dims and churns, branches sway upon the pines ahead, and into the trees she runs into green darkness. Her soundtrack hushes to the sound of her feet padding over heaped pine humus. Then her sound of pleasure when she spots a little mushroom on the woodland floor ahead, wild and fragile and electric with life. From away through the forest comes the sonorous bellow of a stag, with a kind of clang and moan fused together in its depths, as if it's travelled through the wastes of Siberia to reach her. She turns to the hovering Jaymi viewpoint nearby and informs him, "Throughout the far-off mountains of the Arctic, reindeer shy back from every electrical pylon they can see because of their ability to see deep into the ultraviolet range of light beyond the visible spectrum. Ultraviolet frequencies flash and play in the ionized gases that build up around high-voltage power cables' insulator cones. So the reindeer see these overhead cables as lines of ever-flickering lights stretching across wooded mountains out of sight. Thus do their populations fragment into wide but distinct islands between marches of pylons." Before Jaymi can decide how to reply, they reach an island of oak trees, oddly buried here among the pines, all bathed in ultraviolet. And there in the oak shade, a clearing of red sunflowers of a colour so vibrant that they seem to be aflame. Distracted and wild-eyed, Jaymi falls behind, but sees her swooping up above the forests and the mountains and the tundra, then out across the frozen Arctic Ocean, where a permanent sunset hangs against the sea ahead. The last he can hear of her soundtrack is tubular bells clanging huge in the sky and the shrieking of a storm, then a smooth fade to silence.